Gamma Limited, an Indian company, has provided you the following information for 31/3/2019. Now, this is a case on secondary adjustment. And what happens under secondary adjustment, I would just briefly touch upon it because I'm sure you would have looked at it in the lecture, is that if the arm's length price which has been offered by the assessee is different from the price which the tax office agrees, then the difference is something. If the assessee already pays it to the other party, he has to recover it within the prescribed time. If they don't do it, then in that case, they have to charge interest on such amount. So in this case, you're given that there's an Indian company, Gamma Limited, which has provided you the following information. The related enterprise is here. The amount as per the invoice is here, and the amount offered in the ITR is here. Purchase of raw material from Gamma China, 200. The invoice was for 200, but in the ITR, which means that this is the arm's length price as per the assessee. The ITR, the assessee disclosed that the arm's length price is 180. Now, generally what is going to happen is that the arm's length price, if it is adjusted by the assessee himself, which is a suo motu adjustment, then that is something which is considered for secondary adjustment. So in this case, since the purchase of raw material was invoiced at 200 and in the ITR it has been disclosed as 180, if assuming that they had paid 200 to Gamma China, they are supposed to recover the difference, which is 20 from them within the prescribed period. If they don't do it, then of course there will be a secondary adjustment. Payment of royalty to Gamma Pty Singapore. So they paid 100 as royalty, and the arm's length price that they themselves said is 90, which means there is an excess payment of 10 in respect of royalty to the other party. Sale of finished goods is 50, and in the ITR they have disclosed is as 25. Now in this case, if you notice, this is an expense, but this is revenue. So here what they are saying is, even though I have invoiced 50, actually it should be 25. So from a reverse invoice perspective, this same provision will not be applicable. Here, if this entire money has been received, actually there is a higher receipt. Secondary adjustment is applicable when you have paid more, not received more. Correct? So this is something where this adjustment will not be applicable. Interest on loan, they've paid 125, and in the ITR also they've claimed 125. The fee for consultant, they have paid 100, and they have also recovered 100. So if I look at this data, there is an adjustment of 30, which the assessee has himself made in his ITR. This is something which is called the suo motu adjustment. And how much is that? That is equal to 30. Let's see what further details are given to us in the question. You are also provided the following information. So suo motu adjustment was how much? 30. During the course of assessment, the interest paid to Gamma Inc. USA, so how much was the interest paid? 125. What was the deduction which was claimed? 125. Was reduced by the AO to 100 crores. This adjustment was accepted by the company. So there was a downward adjustment of 25, which is accepted by the assessee. So first one was where the assessee himself said that the invoice amount is different, but I believe that the arm's length price should be different. That's the suo motu adjustment, which is 30. The second is there's an adjustment which is done by the tax office and accepted by the assessee. Even these cases are covered under secondary adjustment. So this adjustment of 25 will also be covered for secondary adjustment. Third, during the course of assessment, fee for consultancy paid to Gamma Cyprus was reduced by the AO to 80 crores. The adjustment was not accepted by the company, and it preferred an appeal with the CIT appeal on this matter. Now, if there is a transfer pricing adjustment which is not accepted by the assessee, which is disputed, which is in appeal, on that, secondary adjustment cannot be made till the time the decision is rendered. So therefore, on account of this particular adjustment, there will be no adjustment to the transfer pricing. The company entered into an advance pricing agreement under Section 92CC, wherein the arm's length price of the purchase of raw material was agreed at 180 crores with the relevant authority. Now, when there is an APA and there is some adjustment towards purchase of raw material, which was accepted by the SSE, even on the difference, there is a secondary adjustment. So my total secondary adjustment was 55. I agreed for the adjustment of raw material price as 180. How much was the total price? To this 55, I will add the adjustment made to the price of the raw material. So the raw material price was 180 in the ITR. And what I have done is I have agreed at the price at 180. But because I have already made the adjustment for this, I would not do any further adjustment on this account. And the last adjustment is that the AO determined the sale price of finished goods at 50, which was accepted by the SSE. So the adjustment done until now was 55. Yeah? In the selling price of finished goods, what happened is we saw that the selling price was 50. What was offered was 25. And therefore, I told you that because the SSE has reduced the revenue, there is no CO motor adjustment, and therefore there is no adjustment required to be done. But when the assessment happened, this amount of 25 was actually increased back to 50. And this was accepted by the SSE, which means that for my ITR, I had actually considered an amount of 25. But now I have accepted that it should be 50, which means there's a further adjustment of 25, which needs to be done. So 55 is what I told you was the adjustment earlier. 25 I need to add it, and 80 will be the total adjustment which will be required to be done. Compute the amount of any secondary adjustment which is required to be made under the Income Tax Act 1961 for AY 2021, assuming a rate of interest of 11% and that the transactions were materialized on 31/3/2019. So like I said, transfer pricing adjustment can be made where the SSE himself offers some adjustment. Two, where adjustments are made by the AO and accepted by the SSE. If not accepted by the SSE, they are not considered. Three, if these are determined by an APA. Four, if they are made as per safe harbor rules. And five, arises as a result of the resolution of the assessment by way of mutual agreement procedure. So in this case, one and two is something which is applicable. Third, because the price which was offered in the ITR and the one into agreed into APA was same, there is no further adjustment that needs to be done. Now, if I go back and I have summarized this thing for you. So purchase of raw material, 20 adjustments to be done since this is determined under the APA. Royalty payment 10, accepted by the SSE. Sale of finished goods, adjustment by the AO and accepted by the SSE. Interest on loan, adjustment which is accepted by the SSE, and the last one, fee for consultancy services. Since the adjustment has not been accepted, as per the AO order, nothing needs to be added here. The total comes to 80, which is what I told you earlier. Now, so excess money which is available with the AE is 80. We don't know if they have received anything, so we have assumed that there is nothing which has been received within the prescribed time. So I don't reduce anything here. So 80 is the amount which is receivable from the AE. You are told that the rate of interest is 11%. So therefore, the rate of interest, if applied for 1 year, assuming that the default is for 1 year, the amount of interest which is receivable is 8.8 crores. Now, part B of this question actually says, compute the amount of any secondary adjustment in case the CIT appeal reduces the payment of fee for consultancy services by 10 crores, which is accepted by Gamma Limited. So the AO actually further reduced FTS by 10 crores. 80 was the adjustment earlier. 10 crore is further adjustment, which they accepted. So that means the total adjustment is 90 crores. Assuming a rate of interest of 11% that the transaction materialized in 2019 March and Gamma Limited was able to get excess money from the AE within the prescribed to the extent of 50 crores. So 90 crore is the money receivable. 50 crores is what I got. So 40 is the excess which is lying with them. on that interest at 11% will need to be calculated. So assuming this is for 1 year, it will be 4.4 crores. There's a detailed mechanism for calculating interest, but for the sake of keeping this question simple, we have taken that for one complete year. But if you are given the details as to when the money is received or with respect to when you need to calculate that, then accordingly you will need to adjust the interest.